Indu Puri, the prima donna of Indian table tennis, the undisputed table tennis champion of her era. Indu won the ladies' national table tennis title a record 8 times and 6 times consecutively.
Well, to be frank, I thought of nothing else but table tennis, and I have not given a thought to anything else but the game, right from getting up in the morning and training to practice, and then in the beginning college and then office. It's just been table tennis, and the willingness to, you know, I wanted to come up, do well for myself, for the country, well in international tournaments as well.
Indu brought laurels to the country in many international competitions at home and abroad. Dedication, perseverance, and concentration were the key factors for her stupendous success. As a result, Indu has remained not just a table tennis player, but has become a legend in her lifetime.
Padma, you're a little too eager there to get that smash in. Failing. The 6-inch barrier coming in away. 24-23, Indu Puri up. Can she take it this time? Yes, she does.
There are too many memorable matches for me to recount. But one of the most exciting one was the 1983 finals here in Delhi against Vyoma Parikh, where I was 2 games down in the national final, and then I went on to win the title. And that was the year where I was setting a record of 7 consecutive national titles, so there was tremendous pressure weighing on me at that time. And one of my most disappointing matches was when I lost to Shailaja Soloke in a national final after being 2 games up and 16-12 up. I think till this date I cannot forgive myself for that loss. I am an attacking player, but Usha Sundaraj and Shailaja Soloke were defensive players. And when I'm playing against an attacking player, I don't find it so difficult, but I always thought of myself to be weak against defense. So whenever I played with Shailaja, first of all, it was that psychological barrier of playing against defense. And secondly, she was an equal technically also. She was my rival.
Success does not come easy. One has to strive for it and hunger for it. Indu devoted her life for the game. She practiced with men, which gave her that distinct edge over other women. She exercises regularly to keep in top physical and mental shape.
In 1979 at the World Championships in North Korea, the Indian women's team, we topped the second category and we came into category one, which was a big thing for us. It was a promotion from category two to category one, which entitled us to play in the top category in the subsequent world championships. So that was, I think, Shailaja's and mine, one of our best international performances when we came 16th in the world championship. And just before that, we had won a gold medal in the World Railway Championships, which was held in Czechoslovakia. At that time, Shailaja and myself were both in the railways. And along with Nandini Kulkarni, the three of us had won a gold medal there. And individually, I think, having been ranked in the world, the Commonwealth and the Asia Championship, I think that's what I have done in the international field.
1912 up, Nandini Kulkarni serving. 98, 98. So, we're creating the openings, and Nandini Kulkarni making no mistakes in finishing up.
It was my intense concentration on the table when I was playing a match. It didn't matter what was going on around me. I would just not flicker in my concentration. That and my total dedication to the game. And I didn't have any side interests. I had nothing else but the game to think of.
Indupuri's game was very effortless. And she didn't take any much time to beat anybody. She didn't have to really slog to beat anybody. She was just good in every department of the game. Consider every stroke she had, and basically she didn't lack anything.
She had a lot of dedication. She's worked very hard to reach at the top, and I think these two qualities produce a champion, and that's what she did.
The highest achievement was probably when I beat the world champion Park Yong-sun in the Asian Championships at Kuala Lumpur. And that was a first round in the women's singles. It was a best of three, and it was a league between three people. So when I met Park Yong-sun, well, I never expected to even take a game off her. So in the morning, I did my normal training and running and everything, and I said, I'll just go and do my best. But then I sort of happened to pin her down perfectly. You know, she being a pen holder player, I would give her on her forehand. And the moment she did topspin, I would pin her on her backhand, and she was sort of at a loss of what to do. And I won by 2-1. Well, she burst into tears after the match was over. But when I came out of the arena, I just didn't know what struck me, because I was surrounded by hordes of photographers and newsmen. And I didn't realize till a long time that I had made history at that championship.
Indu Puri, the champion. Today, she is busy training youngsters to make them the champions of tomorrow.
I conduct coaching camps depending on the standard of the players and the age group in which they are in. If I coach very young children, then I start with the basics and I teach them, you know, correct their technique, so that once you start with a wrong action, then it's very difficult to correct it later on.
In her own persuasive way, she imparts the same dedication and enthusiasm to her new role of a coach. Indu Puri quit while on top. Thereafter, there has been a void. There are five youngsters who have been dominating the ladies' table tennis scene ever since. Varsha Cholani. Rinku Gupta. Neoti Roy. Sejal Shah. And Mona Lisa Mehta.
My auntie was a district player and I learned from her at the very beginning. And then I came back to Guwahati and I joined stadium. And from next year onwards, I got a very good coach, NIS coach, Mr. Nihal Singh Thakur. But when I represented Assam the same year, I saw Indu Puri, that time very good player, and other men players like Chandrasekhar, Manjit Dua, and I was very fascinated by their game.
One does need a coach with the sort of a proper technical knowledge, and not just, after all, my father was just a layman, fond of all sport and playing all sport, and he would, you know, coach in a layman's manner and not as a coach should. There was a coaching academy, and if I was offered a good enough terms to take on that academy by coaching small children, juniors, not the national level, you know, people in their formative years, well, I would probably take it up.
Initially, when she took to table tennis and started going to tournaments, was there any opposition in the family?
Certainly not. It was always, though she is my first child, but it was always my dream that my children will be very well known. And I always used to think on those lines. Rapidly, and everything has come so much in life that I just do not know. It has just God's showering of grace. That is all that I can say, because I always thought that my daughter is capable of scaling very great heights. I used to watch whenever they were held in the wherever I used to be. I used to watch all her matches, and I think I was more intense than her. I always used to feel very tense when she was playing.
Thank you.
She's like a boy in the family, like a man in the family. There is nothing that she cannot handle, right? From doing things in the country or doing things abroad or anything, she can handle.
Table tennis academy, as there are academies and other games also, and I think the Table Tennis Federation of India is looking for sponsors to start an academy. But so far till now, we have had mainly players with individual brilliance who have come up on their own without the state help, or I would say an institutional help. So I think once we all get together and everybody here is coaching on their own, but we don't have an integrated effort of coaching. Once the whole country gets together and has a definite plan for the future, then we should have more results.
Tell us your strengths and weaknesses, technically speaking, as a player.
Well, let me come to my weaknesses first. As I had told you earlier, I was never really a very fit player. So I was not very fast in my movements on the table, but I was able to make up by very good anticipation. I could anticipate where the ball is coming and reach there accordingly. So I was not very good in movement, and as far as my strength is concerned, I think it was my consistency. I was able to keep the ball on the table as many times, and also had a very good ball control, which means to be able to put the ball wherever you want on the table. And I think my forehand kill was my main forte. I think my physical weaknesses were made up by my mental strengths. Since I wasn't very good in moving on the table, wasn't very fast, but I was mentally very tough. I had some very good concentration powers and a fighting spirit to be able to win matches from positions of being down several points. A lot of long-term planning, take some juniors between the ages of say 10 and 16 and prepare them for a period of about 10 years so that they are able to do something substantial internationally. And that would involve a lot of physical training in the beginning and then sharpening their technical skills. And we are also lacking in service and receive, as I told you, so we could concentrate more on serving and receiving, because that is the main, that are the main two things in a game, since the point starts with a service. So it depends on how well you are able to receive your opponent's service. I think we do have a lot of a young team in India, and we should be able to improve our position at least in Asia and in the world. And to have a drastic improvement, it would take a long time to jump several positions up the world rankings. But I think we should now be improving our positions.
I knew her ideas. I knew she always used to say that I'm going to retire when I'm at the top. So when she decided to retire, well, I didn't mind it. Because as it is, she had won 8 titles by that time.